Idaho.
A boat.
The salt on your skin and the wind in your hair and the waves as they ebb and they flow. We're miles from the shore and guess what? I don't care.
As for me, I'm about to heave ho.
Hold the line.
Sing you a song of the king of the sea and his pain to the starboard heave ho.
Be wild and free, calling me from fathoms below.
There it is again.
Your Majesty, we ought to head back to the shore.
Indeed, we should.
Not while I'm captain. Now follow that voice.
I love me too. Hello, hello, hello. Sire.
So, what do you have in store for us?
I got a special song just for the occasion. It's going to be performed by none other than your seven lovely daughters. I wrote this number for my star pupil.
And who might that be?
Your youngest, Ariel. Such a voice, that child. Notes as clear as ice. Pitch as pure as water.
Let the merriment begin!
Are we are the daughters of Triton, great father who loves us and named us well.
A Quarta, a Dreamer,
a Rispin,
a Tina,
a Della,
a Mono,
and Ariel.
Wasn't even Aaron's fault. That know-it-all seagull started going on and on and on and on.
Seagull?
Seagull, you went to the surface again, didn't you?
Nothing happened.
You could have been seen by one of those barbarians, one of those humans.
They're not barbarians.
They have traps and harpoons, Ariel. Like it or not, you are my youngest, my baby, so why I worry about you the most?
I'm old enough to look after myself.
As long as you live under my reef, you obey my rules.
If you just listen to me for
that
once...
That is the last time you're ever swimming to the surface, you understand?
You're so unfair!
If only she were here, she'd know just what to say. She'd firmly and yet gently help the girl to find a way. She'd know what to forbid and what we must allow. She'd have the strength and patience that I lack somehow. And oh, what would I give to have her back? Right.
Now, sire. It's difficult, sure. But you gotta toughen up another meltdown! For Ariel's sake, I'm telling ya, that child needs constant supervision. Someone who can watch over her, keep her out of trouble.
That's not a bad idea. Someone to safeguard her every move.
Her every dog paddle.
For every side
stroke. Every dive.
And you're just a crab to do it.
What?
Oh,
I was a kid, a squirmy little squid. I was number seven, born of seven little girls. Seven little pearls, pretty as could be.
Perfect to a T,
all except for me. Ugly as a slug, hideous to hug. Daddy found me lonesome and disgusting, I could tell. They all got adored, I just got ignored. Plus tweezers, guilt, a magic shell. Used to belong to my papa Poseidon. Of lethal hexes and spells, my little sea snakes, the perfect gift for a dangerously unstable child. Most of all, Daddy loved one sister, so feminine, so fresh, so fine. I would watch as he hugged and kissed her, and I hated her guts from the bottom of mine. Daddy's little angel, Daddy's little queen, such a little frilly femme. She was seeming spice, everything nice, and I dreamed and I schemed how to put her on ice. Daddy's little angel, how could I compete with a girl so heaven sent? Just one sail from the shell and back to heaven she went. Next, what did I do? Daughter number two, flung her in a whirlpool, I left her spinning around.
started 3 and 4, washed up on shore. Sadly, 5 and 6 were never found. And it didn't make my father love me.
Aww.
But it didn't bring me down
again. No, no.
It was sad though when Dad got that very rare and lethal flu.
So true.
Poor you,
boo hoo.
With no sisters in the line above me, I inherited the whole darn show.
Was it fun? Oh, a ton.
So much fun, I forgot that my dad also had an additional ton. Yes, a ton, still ate one, but I figured, so what? Still, that snot-nosed little baby grew and grew. He grew into you, no well. Triton, a male heir. As soon as he came of age, he stole everything from me. Every ocean, every lake, every pond, every puddle. So, my dear Flotsam and Jetsam, it's time I took revenge. Revenge on what he loved most! For now he has a child, a sweet, rather wild, and she has him wrapped around her flimsy little fin. She will be our inn. She'll be what we use, baby cat years, there's no able lift.
Daddy's little angel,
daddy's little pet, daddy's little priceless gem.
So sassy,
so small,
the key to his heart.
Ruiner as it were, it'll rip him
apart.
Yes, daddy's little princess, she's the one to get. Now just take it from a pro.
Oh, just get daddy's little angel, trust me. What's the word? But
part of that world.
Oh, I'm sorry. I can't make out a heartbeat. No, look. He's breathing. Oh, Scuttle, just look at him. Isn't he just beautiful? What would I give to live where you are? What would I pay to stay here beside you? What would I do to see you smiling at me? I don't know when, I don't know how, but I know something's starting right now. Watch and you'll see. Someday I'll be
laughter in the ripple of the waves against the shoreline. I can see her smiling in the moonlight as it settles on the sand. I can feel her waiting just beyond the pale horizon, singing out her melody too lovely to withstand. Voice, it's there as dusk is falling. And her voice, it's there as dawn steals by. Pure and bright, it's always there, all day, all night, and still I hear it calling. Voice.
John, there you are, a human. You fell in love with a human.
I didn't choose it, just sort of happened.
Oh, child.
I thought maybe, just maybe, you'd be happy for me.
Happy for you. Happy. Cause you're gone plumb crazy now! Child, you got to get your head out of the clouds and back onto the water where it belongs.
But I don't belong here. As hard as I've tried, if only I could be up there walking on the very same ground, breathing the very same air.
Down here is your home. The human world, oh, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there.
You're wrong, I swear.
Believe me, John, it's true. The seaweed is always cleaner in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right there on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more is you looking for? Oh, under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better, the way it's wetter, take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While we're devoting full time to floating under the sea. here or the fish is happy as off of the waves they roll.
The fish on the land ain't happy, they're sad cause they in the fall. The fish in the mold is lucky, they eat for worse some days. One day when the host gets hungry,
guess who gone beyond the plate? Oh, oh, under the sea.
Under the sea.
Under the sea.
Under the sea.
Nobody beat us flyers and eat us in fricassee. We want the land folks love to cook. Under the sea, we off the hook. We got no troubles, life is the bubbles. Under the sea. Under the sea. Under the sea. Since life is sweet, yeah, we gotta beat it naturally. Even the surgeon and the ray, they get the urn and start to play. We got the spirit, you got to hit it. Under the sea.
Ariel. He ruined all my things. My human stuff. If he really and truly loved me, then he'd never.
Oh, child, it's only because he loves you.
He sure is a funny way of showing it. He can break everything I own, but he can't break me.
Well, you might just break his heart.
And some friend you turned out to be, taking him here to my secret place?
I pray you'll wake up from this madness, and soon you're swimming in some very dangerous waters. I don't want to lose you, Ariel.
Fins, my darling.
Don't be shy, Ariel, darling. It's me, your Aunt Ursula.
I shouldn't be here.
Nonsense, we're family.
Father says you're wicked and hateful.
Yes, but he says the same things of humans. Doesn't he, Schnookums? And we both know that's not true, don't we?
Why did he banish you?
The ocean wasn't big enough for the both of us. And now I see he's driven you away, too.
He doesn't understand.
Oh, but I do, babykins. We're so very like you and I. Gals with ambition. Nothing scares a man more, does it? Poor souls, with no one else to turn to.
I admit that in the past I've been a nasty. They weren't kidding when they called me, well, a witch. But you'll find that nowadays
I've mended all my ways, repented, seen the light and made a switch. True,
yes, and I fortunately know a little magic. It's a talent that I always have possessed. And here lately, please don't laugh, I use it on behalf of the miserable, lonely and depressed pathetic, poor unfortunate souls in pain. One longing to be thinner, that one who wants to get the girl, and do I help them? Yes, indeed. Those poor unfortunate souls, so sad, so true. They come flocking to my cauldron, crying, spells, Ursula, please, and I help
them. Yes, I do. Now it's happened once or twice. Someone couldn't pay the price, and I'm afraid I had to break them cross the call. Yes, I've had the odd complaint, but on the whole, I've been a saint to those poor, unfortunate souls. Here's my best offer, babykins. I know a spell that will turn you into a human for 3 days. It's got a procedural claw, sort of a squid pro quo. Before the sun sets on the third day, you've got to get dear old Princey to kiss you. If you do, you'll stay human forever.
And if I don't?
Oh, nothing drastic, darling, I'm sure. Oh, look, small print. Your soul is mine forever, and you're doomed to spend eternity in my watery, hell-soaked lair. Lawyers, don't you just love them? Of course, there is one more thing. My fees.
I don't have anything.
I'm not asking for much. I'm only asking for... your voice.
My voice?
Your grand Peppy Poseidon gave his magic trident to your father, and this was his gift pour moi.
Your magic shell.
You've heard about it?
Father says you die without it.
Die? Oh, please, it's a bauble, a vessel for your voice. Trust me, your vibrato, your legato, even your belt, they'll all be safe and sound in here.
If I give away my voice, I'll never see my sisters, my father.
You'll have your looks. You'll have your looks. Your pretty face. And don't underestimate the power of body language. The men up there don't like a lot of blabber. They think a girl who gossips is a bore. Yes, on land it's much preferred for ladies not to say a word. And after all, do what is idle prattle for? Come on, they're not all that impressed with conversation. True gentlemen avoid it when they can. But they dote and swoon and fawn on a lady who's a drawn. It's she who holds her tongue who gets a man. Come on, you poor unfortunate soul. Go ahead, make your choice. I'm a very busy woman and I haven't got all day. It won't cost much, just your voice. You poor unfortunate soul. Want to cross that bridge, my sweet, you've got to pay the toll. Take a gulp and take a breath. Go ahead and sign the scroll. Sluts and jets, and now I've got a girl. The boss is order all. You poor unfortunate soul. Sing your voice over to me.
I'll decipher it for myself. Aha! It's your hairdo. You've been meeting the Dingle Hopper.
She's got legs, you idiot! She traded her voice to a sea witch and got legs.
No, not your beautiful pipes.
Yossi, not a sound.
Aw, kid, it hurts me to say it, but that was a lousy swap.
What would her father say? I tell ya, what her father would say. He's going to kill himself and cry, but that's what he'd say.
She's got just 3 days.
3 days to what?
Make the prince fall in love with her.
Rick. We'll never know the truth. She won't speak. Not a single solitary word. Do what you must to make her presentable. Grab the tub, a proper frock.
Getting a strength back, dearie. I give a farthing to you just to hear her thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
like this. Oh, look over here. Oh my God, Calvary Yard, and what might they be? Something splendid, maybe. Oh, look over here. Could you bust? Isn't it just be dazzling, dazing, utterly amazing? Gazing around, it's like to die. Just seeing it feels so good. I'd scream if I only could. I'd hoped and wished and wondered what I'd do. Walking around, strange as it seems, somewhere beyond my wildest dreams. Look at her there, looking round, Warwick Sound
just keeps on gawking.
Weird how she's not talking. Look at her stare,
lucky miss,
chosen like this to stay for dinner.
What does he say in her?
Hush now, girl, she's simply shy.
Just picture the table chat, when tired even that.
Pipple, ladies, in 2 short nights the prince shall host his contest. Young ladies will be singing themselves silly all to win his heart. Tonight he'll savor some quiet.
A palette. Hop heads in the classic technique. First you pound the fish flat with a mallet. Then you slice through the skin, gives the belly a slice. Then you up some salt in. Ha 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 ha! Cause that makes it taste nice. Sotolo, I have missed one. Shh. What is this? How on earth could I miss such a sweet little succulent crab? Quel dommage! What a loss! You belong in the sauce with the flour, I think, just a dab. Then I'll stuff with bread. It won't hurt, you'll be dead, and you'll surely be lucky you are. Cause it's going to be hot. Ooh la 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 la! In my big copper pot! Toutes les mains pensant. Au revoir!
Dancing is a language that is felt instead of heard. You can whisper, sing, or shout without so much as a word. Try it. Go on. Like so. your emotions tell your body what to do. See how much a single gesture can reveal, and every single step, every little step is one step closer to talking loud and clear.
Out of the firing pan and into the fire, the things I do for you, young lady. Now, I know what I should do. I should march you right back home to your father. March you right back. Well, you'll be miserable for the rest of your life. Oh, it's true. I got no backbone. All right, Chad, I am in. Now, we need to come up with a plan to make that prince want to kiss you. First thing you got to do, you got to batter your eyelids like this. Then, you got to pucker your lips like this. Now put two and two together. Ooh, that's good! You'll have the prince in the palm of your hand. Now, off to bed with you. Shoo, shoo.
Girls, just one night and they're already dining together.
They were dancing cheek to cheek.
I should have known. There's only one thing more potent than my black magic.
The power of true love.
No! Teenage hormones. Seems the little tart is off to quite a start. Just one night and Principo is wallowing in bliss. Think what they will do by sunset number two.
What?
Idiots! Go off and block that kiss.
Yes, your wretchedness. The meanwhile, her poor proud pappy, bet he's wondering where his baby's been.
Or he's sick,
so upset,
not happy. Soon he'll guess that, oh yes,
all the fun will begin. Daddy and his angel, gonna hurt once my plan is in full flow.
Once a kiss goes amiss, then the girl will be mine. What she's had, then her dad will be caught on my line. Then a sail from the shell and up to heaven they'll go.
Nothing is happening.
All day on horseback, a picnic, and now this, and not so much as a peck on the cheek.
Only 24 hours left, and oh, he'll be married off, and poor Ariel, she'll be left deep sixed.
We gotta do something, and quick.
But what?
We gotta create the right kind of mood.
Oh, I know, like something romantical, like candlelight and shampoo.
Nonsense, it don't take all that. Everything we need, we got right here. Percussion? Something about her, and I don't know why, but you're dying to try. You wanna kiss the girl. Yes, you want her. Look at her, you know you do. Possible she wants you to. There's one way to ask her. Don't take a word, not a single word. Go on and kiss the girl. Sing with me now. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, my oh my. Look like that boy too shy. Ain't gonna kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, ain't that sad? Ain't it a shame? Too bad he gonna miss the girl.
You know, I really ought to know the name. Maybe I could guess. All right. Annabelle. Alexandria. Beatrice.
Ariel. Her name is Ariel.
Ariel? Hey, Ariel. That's really pretty. All right.
Now's your moment. Floating in the blue lagoon. Boy, you better do it soon. No time will be better. She don't say a word, and she won't say a word until ya kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, don't be scared. You got the moves prepared. Go on and kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, don't stop now. Try to hide it how you wanna kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, float along and listen to the song. The song say, kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, music play. Do what the music say. Go on and kiss the girl. You've got to kiss the girl. Go on and kiss the girl. You've got to kiss the girl. Kiss the girl.
Block that kiss!
Merciful, Triton.
Where is she?
I pray I'll keep calm.
Where is Ariel?
Oh, she'd be so angry if she knew I was here.
I entrusted my youngest daughter to you, and what happened? I ought to have you shelled. I ought to have you cracked.
He almost was, Your Greatness. And all for Ariel.
And you. You ought to be ashamed of yourself, too. What type of tragedy will it take?
A tragedy involving the sea witch, to be exact.
The sea witch?
What?
Oh, dear, dear, dear.
These two eels came and they took her straight to Ursula, and she traded her voice for a pair of legs.
She bartered her voice away.
My son said tomorrow that child could be given up her very soul.
Her soul?
And all to that wicked sister of yours.
It's time I settle things once and for all.
If only you could know the things I long to say. If only I could tell you what I wish I could convey. It's in my every glance, my heart's an open book. You'd see it all at once if only you would look. If only you could glimpse the feeling that I feel. If only I could tell you what I'm dying to reveal. The dreams I can't declare, the needs I can't deny. You'd understand them all if only you'd try. All my secrets, you would learn them. All my longings, you'd return them. Then the silence would be broken. Not a word would need be spoken.
What is it about her that's so wonderfully, impossibly familiar? Why do I feel dizzy in a way I've only felt but once before? How come when she looks at me it seems like time stops moving? Almost like that way it did that day upon that shore. But that
fall, if only it were true, if only for a
while. Where's that
fall? If only you would notice how I ache behind my smile.
That
I guess you never will. I guess it doesn't show, but if I would give if only you could know.
Bless your child. Tomorrow the prince will have his pick of any princess in the land. How can a little mermaid compete with that?
How could I have pushed her to the point of having no one left to turn to? What if I have lost her and it's all my fault? She's gone!
Ah, that voice!
If only I knew how!
If only I could know!
Where's that voice?
If only there were time, I know we'd kiss at last!
Ah, that voice!
Why turn back time? I change my way!
Just one more day for the time keeps racing forward. Almost past.
I'll try to understand.
It has to happen now.
I'll keep my temper.
Now I wish that girl would have been a she's one.
To soul me one more day until I have to go.
If only. Maybe I'll find that voice, but I'll lose her.
If only you.
Welcome, dear friends, to our contest. The first that our kingdom has ever seen. We gather today for a vocal display, so our prince may at last choose a queen. These six princesses possess the most accomplished voices in all the land. Tonight, one of you shall join Prince Eric on the throne. May the best one win.
Her voice. I'll know it the moment I hear it.
Listen to this, clear as can be. You'll know I'm it when I hit my high C. Wouldn't you think I'm the girl who has everything, everything, walking display of a bird heart so clear. Can't you hear? I'm the one, I'm the one, I'm the one, I'm the one, I'm the one. I'm the one.
Surely one of these lovely voices matches the music in your heart.
I wish I could say yes, but she's not here. Ariel?
Oh, no, child, you mustn't.
No, wait, Grim. Let her try.
Poor lost child. I'd so hoped, dear Eric, that you'd find love somewhere in this room.
Maybe I have. Maybe I was just too blind to see it.
That's impossible. She didn't utter a sound.
No? Well, I heard every single note, as clear as a bell. That must mean something.
Perhaps it does.
Ah.
That's it.
the voice.
Could it be another contestant?
Right on cue.
Done with my daughter?
I haven't done anything to her. She traded away her voice. And for what? Human heartbreak.
Give her back to me.
Not on your life. It so happens that your daughter signed a contract.
No.
Even drew a little heart above the eye. Is it binding? Goodness, yes. Unbreakable, unless.
Unless.
There is a little something we could try.
Go on.
Yes, perhaps we could arrange a sort of trade-off. Maybe swap your daughter's soul for, say, your own.
What?
Sign the scroll and set her free, or else she comes with me to suffer through eternity alone. The mute little hatchling drowning in her own sorrow with no voice left to cry out your name. I'm waiting.
It's not my soul you're after. It's my power.
Which would you rather be? A king of the sea or a father to your little girl?
Ariel?
Poseidon has been once again made whole. All the magic of the trident and the shell in my control. And now dark showering forever over ocean, sea, and shore. See for yourself how banishment feels. You poor unfortunate soul!
Look at how she's got the shell!
My black magic now.
My voice, this spell is broken.
Give it back to me.
If it breaks, you die.
You really believe that? After all the lies he told you.
Lies? What lies?
You told her the world above was hideous. And what was it instead?
Beautiful. Beautiful beyond compare.
He'd say anything to turn you against Prince Apu and his kind. He's shameless. He'd even say they murdered your mother.
Wait a second. If humans didn't do it, then who did?
It was you. All this time, I've been blaming them, and it was you!
Who, me? I couldn't hurt a seahorse.
Excuse me.
Liar! My shell! No!
Not you, my sisters. This place, the only place I've ever truly called home.
I'm the one who's at fault, Ariel. Cursing humans when all along...
There's goodness in people. I've seen it.
Even when I couldn't. I'm proud of you. Your mother would have been too. Somehow,
in a blink of an eye when my back was turned. You grew up. You love him very much, don't you?
Look, sire!
Ariel!
Eric!
It's been you all along, hasn't it?
Yes.
Who are you?
This is my father.
I'm King Triton.
Astonishing, I must say. It defies plausibility.
Your Majesty, at last, I found someone who makes me eager to seize the future and claim my birthright as king. But if I slip out to the sea sometimes, I don't think she'll mind, because she'd be right there next to me, keeping us both on course. With your permission, I'd like to make her my wife.
My permission? Ariel can speak for herself.
Yes, Eric. Yes.
If only you could stay and never say goodbye. If only I could make time stop, believe me, I would try. But fathers have to learn that daughters have to grow. And if you truly love them, you must let them go.
And oh, I love you so, if only you.
All tales and superstitions, eh, Grim?
So that's really the king of the sea and she's his daughter?
Yes. Does that upset you?
Heavens no, I'm just relieved she's royalty.
Just you and me.